Hi, so far in the video series of CSS, we have seen the various options of making the borders around the text and using the padding, how can we pass some space between the border and the text. Now, in this particular video, we will see how we can change the dimensions of the border as per our requirement so that we can make the boxes of different sizes, maybe smaller or larger. So let's have a practical implementation where we will see about the dimensions using the available CSS options.
So as far as the implementation of the dimension is concerned, here we are going to try some dimension of width 400 pixel and height 100 pixel. So here I'm just trying to show you how can you pass the height and width for any particular dimension. So let's save it, and here you can see like, okay, this is the dimension of height 100 pixel and width 400 pixel. As you can see, it is not just started from the corner because the padding, margin, everything is out there. Alright, so because of margin, it started 10 pixel away. Now, let's see how we can make some changes inside it. So basically, we can also pass something like the minimum height, minimum width, or maximum height, maximum width. So in that particular context, here in this particular example, I'm passing maximum height, means doesn't matter the content which you are putting inside, but the maximum height which this particular box will take will be of about 10 pixel. So obviously we have a lot of things here. We have some number of lines. After that, after some line breaks, we have an image. So probably all those things will not be a part of the maximum height 10 pixel, but still the line, the height of that particular box will remain as it is. So let's refresh and see. So here you can clearly see like this is the 10 pixel height, but still all the content is not inside that. So if you want to restrict in any particular circumstances, you can use the minimum height or maximum height. Similarly, I can do that for minimum height as well. So minimum, it will be 10 pixel, but maximum it can take up to the content. All right. So now you can see the content is here. So the box size got changed. And mind it, the image is outside the paragraph, obviously. So it will not, the box will not cover the image part. Similarly, let's say minimum height is 100 pixel and let's remove some of the things inside. Like I will remove a couple of lines, I'll refresh, but even you see the content is less, but as I said, the minimum height is 100 pixel, it will take 100 pixel whether it is required or not. And very similarly, we have the concept for minimum width and maximum width as well. So let's say I'll say maximum width is 400 pixel. I'll just remove this minimum from here. I'll just take the default 100 pixel height. Alright, now if I will put some shorter width, alright, so now maximum width is 40 pixel, the content is not able to adjust inside, but still you can see somehow it managed because maximum width which you can pass here is 40 pixel. Similarly, if you can want, you can pass the minimum width as well. So minimum it's 40, but if content demands more, it can goes up to more. Alright, so these are the various changes which you can make while creating a box with some dimensions for a specific content of your DOM.